Okay, so in this particular video, we're going to talk about different ImageReady features and tools that you will be using. Now, we're only going to be using a few tools, and I believe that we can keep it as simple as possible so that you can create your video templates quickly and easily. Now, if your ImageReady has different boxes open, then I would advise you just to minimize most of them. What I'm going to be using are three separate windows. If you click on window, I'll be using the tools, which looks like this. So if that's open, then don't close that down. And then I'm going to be using layers, which you can find here. The layers, history, and actions box. I'll be using the layers and the history. History is just in case you mess up and you want to go back. I'll be using a lot of layers, about 3 to 4 layers, in this particular video. Layers are basically defined as areas that can make up a whole image. Let's say, for example, the video squeeze page template. I could have a layer for the image, I could have a layer for the video box, I could have a layer for the background, and I could have a layer for other things. Basically, layers make it easier for you to produce a final image. In the specific tool area, we're going to use the magic wand tool. It allows us to select things very easily. And we're going to use a slice tool and the slice select tool. We're going to use the paint bucket tool. And then we're going to use these colors here. We're also going to use the slice window. If you go to window and click on slice, when we actually slice up the image, you will actually be able to use this. It's very simple to use and very easy to use. Now, the two tools that I'm going to use that you might not necessarily understand right now is slicing. Now, I'm not going to talk about slicing in depth right now. We'll actually have a separate video that will talk about slicing, how to slice, and how to do it so that when you export it to a web page, it looks nice. So those are the specific features and tools that we're going to use. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to find the video dimensions and how to start creating your video template.